Hello everyone, Prism here. It's been quite a while. Sorry for not doing YouTube for a while. I kind of just got bored and did other things. So, I'm probably not going to do any more YouTube videos, or if I do one, it's going to be very rare, just because, I don't really feel like it. So, I'm going to play one of my favorite games. Dark Souls again, why not? And thought, why not record it? I don't really have anything better to do, so. Let's just start, I guess. Be thief just for the master key. Switch, by the way, because it's the most convenient for me. Might as well.
In the age of ancients. Shrouded by fog. A land of grey crags, arch trees, and everlasting dragons.
I'm gonna have volume control.
But then there was fire. And with fire came disparity. Heat and cold, life and death, and of course, light and dark.
Ah.
Then from the dark they came and found the souls of lords within the flame.
Skeleton man.
Nito, the first of the dead. The witch of Isolde and her daughters of chaos.
Dark Souls is actually pretty cool if you haven't played it. Definitely.
Lin, the Lord of
Try and play it if you haven't.
And his
very difficult,
knights.
But very fun. It's one of my favorite games.
And the furtive pygmy. So easily forgotten. With the strength of lords. they challenge the dragons. Queen's mighty lords lead her as champions. The witches lead great fires to earth.
That's not good. Or maybe, I don't know.
Even now, there are only embers.
I have like 10 hours of spare time. Just read the lore of this game. It's pretty interesting. Nights.
And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side.
Zombies. Yeah, basically for anyone who doesn't really know, Dark Souls is kind of a game just where everyone's like a zombie, sort of. Uh-oh, there's one of
them. Yes, indeed. The dark sign brands the undead. And in this land,
it's a jail.
The undead are corralled and led to the north.
In this video, I only really intend to get past, like,
where they are locked away
a little bit and make it to the first bell.
The end of the world.
I don't really expect anyone watching to, any one of the three people watching this video to really know anything about Dark Souls, so.
This. Is your fate.
Kind of just say stuff. I don't know. I'm not. This is kind of why I don't do YouTube really much anymore. I don't really have much to say. I mean, I have lots of ideas for videos. I just don't want to make them. Is this? He looks like a friend. Bye bye. There we are, boy old McGee. Alright, let's see, what did this man give us? A key. Let's escape our cell. Whoops. No! Uh-oh, this man is sad. Lunch. Never mind, all. So one reason the combat in Dark Souls is kind of hard, you can't exactly just... The combat's really fun, it's just like... You can't just wail on enemies, because your stamina, every time you attack, uses it. And if it runs out, you can't attack. So you kind of have to conserve it. Might as well rest. First Atomic Fire. You'll be seeing these a lot. I will be skipping some areas, but I'll try not to do glitches. I will use one just so I don't have to farm enemies for souls, which is basically the currency of this game. Uh-oh, here's the first boss. You're not supposed to beat him, because if you punch him, you just do like 2 damage. You're supposed to just run past him into this door. But if you pick fire bombs as like your starting item, you can kill him. And instead of dropping like an escape key, he gives you his hammer if you kill him the first time. Which I can't use because I need 46 strength. Ow. And I only have 9. Excuse me. I need to get a shield. Thank you. I don't really need this shield. I'll just grab it because I can. Thank you for my dagger. Alright, let's go. Now we have some to attack with other than our fists. Excuse me, sir. Alright. I'm certain we won't get any balls in the face. Uh-oh. Oh, how dare you break this wall. Here's this man. Thank you for helping us.
I'm here. I'm done for. I'll die soon. I wish to ask something of you. You and I do both.
Hear me out? Fine.
Regrettably. But perhaps you can keep it. There's an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead, arch, and thine exodus from the undead asylum, maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient lords.
When
thou ringeth the bell of awakening.
Ooh, and now bells.
You oh, an Estus flask.
Thank you for healing.
Oh.
Ooh, the escape key. Normally, that key drops from the asylum demon, the first boss. But since I killed him the first time, I got his hammer instead.
No, I must be putting, and thank you.
Alright. Goodbye. Goodbye. I should probably put my Estus flask. So I can actually. Oh, it's already equipped. Healing. Alright. We're almost out of the tutorial area. So I'm only gonna go to the first bell for this first video. I don't really like using a dagger. Jeez, dude, I've never had trouble with these guys. Although I haven't played Dark Souls in a hot minute, so. I'll take out this guy too, but not. Get the parry. Yeah, I might, since I've played this game and beaten it like 5 times, I think. I'm probably gonna make the game look easy, but it's not. I'll just tell you right now. So normally, this is where you re-encounter and properly fight the asylum demon, but I killed him the first time, so we can just, we're free to leave. Alright, we're free to go. First, I would like to grab some money. Thank you. So souls are basically the currency in this game. And those soul items you find around, you can just use them to get money. Alright. Let's head off to the Lord Realm proper.
In the ancient legends, it is stated
escaped our jail.
One day an undead shall choose. To leave the undead asylum in pilgrimage. To the land of the ancient lords.
That's the main area. Oop, here we are. Main world. Where are you going to take me? To a cliff? Oh, we're gonna crash. Ouch. I rate that a 3-star ride on Uber. The first real bonfire. Level up and kindle bonfires. Kindling is basically how you refill your Estus flasks and get more. They changed it in Dark Souls 2 and I think Dark Souls 3, where you need to find shards. I haven't played Dark Souls 3 because I don't have a console for it, but I will certainly play it when I get the chance. So basically, in Dark Souls 1, when you die, you go hollow and become a zombie, and you can't boost your number of Estus flasks. I'll block stuff. Alright, let's grab a few goodies while we're here. Dying in this game and going hollow isn't really a big change, but they changed it in future games, like in Dark Souls 2. When you die, you lose your maximum health, goes down, which really sucks in my opinion. It's one of the main things I don't actually like about Dark Souls 2. Dark Souls 2 is my favorite Souls game. So, I significantly doubt I'll make a video on it, but if I'm ever bored, I might make a video playing Dark Souls 2. Let's just equip some more. These homeward bones just return you to the last bonfire you used, so you don't have to walk back there. And, yeah, by the way, Dark Souls doesn't have fast travel until, like, you're halfway through the game. Uh-oh, skeletons. These guys are dangerous. Let's just grab a few things while we're here. Binoculars too, because why not? Ooh, ouch. I think this is the first time I've really died there. Well, first death. It's not the worst thing. I think that's actually the first time I've died to those skeletons. Also, when you die, you lose all your money, and you can go back and grab it, but I'm not gonna do that. And before we go to the first main area, I just wanna grab something real quick. down in a later game area, and she can just take an elevator. It's so weird. One thing that's really weird is, in real life, I'm not the best with directions, but for some reason in games, I can, like, play through them once and know how to navigate areas very well. I really don't know why. I don't know what that is. I wish I had that ability in real life. Like, just taking a walk down the sidewalk and to, like, a grocery store, and the next time over, I know how to get there again. Which I can kind of do, but not very well. Oops, don't want to fall off the edge. Just gonna grab a firekeeper soul here real quick. Which basically make your Estus flasks heal you more. And be careful of these ghosts, because you can't hit them unless they're cursed, or you use a transient curse item. And you're also not really meant to be here this early in the game. Alright. Oh, I didn't know you could get interrupted when using a homebrew bomb. Whoops. My camera keep unfocusing. I did get a better camera, by the way, to record. I'm just using my iPad instead of my phone. It has a much better camera, so it should make it better from recording. I wish I had a way to just, like, an Elgato Stream Deck or something like that, to just plug in my Switch. Or whatever I do to record, so I don't have to just point my camera at the TV, but I don't really have a computer either to do proper recording, so. And I rarely record anyway, so this is fine. Alright, let's just improve my Estus Flask real quick. Estus Flask plus one, now we heal more with each drink. Let's go to the first real area. I'm only gonna ring the first bell for this video. It's been 22 minutes. Alright. I should really equip that spear, if I can use it. Oh, wait, I can't use that. Hang on. No, I need 13 strength to use it. Just barely too weak. Probably two-handed. There we go. Ow! Stop throwing fireballs. I also don't really start as a thief when I play Dark Souls, so I'm not really used to these starting stats. If I die here, I'm gonna be kind of embarrassed. Oh, they're coming. I'll just stick with the knife. Feels like I always do worse when I'm recording. Like, normally I just cruise through this first area. Thank you, sir. This ring basically lets you, when you die, you don't lose your money, or if you're not hollow, you don't become a zombie, basically. But then the ring breaks. Alright, we're almost to the first real area. Oh, fireball. Thank you. I mainly use halberds in this game, or like greatswords, so I'm not really used to a dagger. I can just wrap up this soul just for some cash. Alright, first area, undead burg. This guy throws bombs. Oh, that's close. Another soul. Starting with zero poise. This makes these fights very annoying. The only good reason to pick Thief as a starting class is so you can get the Master Key for free, which is the most broken item in the game, which basically lets you open most locked doors without needing the key for it. Just get a better shield. Best with parry timing in this game either. I don't really want to use it for certain enemies. Alright, when I first played Dark Souls, and the first time I played this game, I didn't know this hidden little area was a thing. I always thought that platform was kind of pointless. But here's this dude. Looks like a normal enemy, but nope, you can buy stuff from him. Oh, wooden arrows are only three. Alright, I'm not gonna use a bow, but I am going to use these arrows for a glitch, so I don't have to farm souls from enemies to buy things. I might use this just to level up a little bit. But I really don't want to just kind of get max leveled. Oops. So basically what I did there is, you can, in the remastered version, you can kind of open two menus at once, and like, glitch out the menus to make it think you're dropping a bunch of soul items, and you actually use like, 400 of them. Take the leadership one off. Don't need that. I'll take the residence key. I don't really need it, but it's convenient to have. Should I get his katana? Nah, he can stay alive. Also, you can kill basically any NPC you see. NPC you meet, excuse me. And they usually drop unique items, like that guy. He drops a katana, which you can use. But I prefer to use, like, spears and stuff. So I won't kill him, he can stay alive. Oh, I should probably equip that chain while I got. These undeads are really annoying to deal with when you have zero poise, because every attack staggers you. Alright, poise in this game is basically like when you get hit. I'm not very good at explaining things, but like basically when you get hit, the lower poise you have, the more you're likely to stagger, I think. So basically when your armor has more poise, you stagger less. So when enemies hit you, nothing really happens. Right now I'm just going around grabbing a few things before we actually fight bosses and stuff. But the first boss is coming up. Oh well. First real boss, I should say. Hang on, was there an item back here? Oh, you can jump down here. I'm pretty sure you can just jump to lower bird and fight Capra Demon right away. Never done that. But I might. Before we go back to the main route and stop grabbing stuff, I'll just go through here real quick. Let's grab some trash. Literal trash. Enough screwing around, let's go to the main area. What's this area? Oh, how'd you get up here? Where'd you even come from, dude? Yeah, did I grab the heavy crossbow? Yeah, I did. Alright, enough screwing around. Let's actually make our way to the first real boss. Should level up a little bit. I have a few hundred extra souls, a few hundred thousand extra souls. Alright, because I did that soul glitch, I have like a thousand extra souls than you normally have. I'm just gonna do that one more time to do a quick level up. I don't intend to keep doing this, but I might rarely do it just to avoid grinding souls and leveling up very slowly. And yeah, that soul duplication glitch really only works on the remastered version of Dark Souls, so if you try and do it on the PS3 version or the PC version, it won't work. But I think there's another way to duplicate items in that in those versions. My stamina point. also, while like the stats and stuff in this game like may seem complicated, it's not really that complicated. Like, you can kind of ignore most of these. Sort of, not really, I guess. It just kind of takes some getting used to. I could use a swine if I want to. For the spear. No, why not? I'll equip it as a secondary weapon. Oops. 138 damage. Normally, your stats are not normally this high in the beginning of the game. I'll use the Ultra Great Sword for a little bit of time. Also, I'm pretty sure this type of sword is a real thing. Like, a 7-foot tall sword. So, like, the thing about the weapons in this game is that they have, like, a whole bunch of different stats, and, like, they all have different pros and cons. So, like, these Ultra Great Swords do a lot of damage, but they're far high stats to use. They're heavy, and they're fairly slow to attack with, while something like a spear is fairly light and requires usual stats to use, but it doesn't do a whole lot of damage. I'll put my heater shield. You also have a long reach, which is nice. The gold pine resin so we can get a lightning weapon. Oh shoot, I didn't kindle, so I only have 5 Vestas. Also, Ultra Great Swords use a lot of stamina to attack with, so can't really spam them. I'll fight this Black Knight and get the blue tier stone. Why not? These guys are pretty hard to deal with, but if you know what to do, you can kind of cheese them. Like, for certain enemies, if you get right behind them, you can do like a backstab. Oops. Backstab cheese. Tearstone rings, so now when our health is low, we get increased defense. I forgot to kill that bonfire, so I only have 5 Estus. Not the best to have. Uh-oh. That hit me. The cool thing about like spears and halberds though is you can use them with your shield up, which I honestly don't think I've ever used. There goes my clock. Alright, first real boss. Also, I don't think I'm gonna do the DLC. if I get that far. Those bosses are very, very difficult, even for someone who's experienced in Dark Souls. I should get healed for this fight, I'm good. Ouch. Get a lightning's way handle real quick. No boss in the way. Uh-oh. It's a Taurus demon. Thankfully, there's this convenient ladder and this convenient tower. So, punch attack. That's a lot of health. Damage, but since I'm using one of the best weapons in the game, because you can get it at the very beginning, I kind of just melted him. Alright, we're getting close to the first bell and the end of this video. Probably like 10 more minutes. But first, one of the most popular characters. Hello, Solaire.
Hello. I am hooked now that I can eat you fine. No, no, no.
Also, if you kill him, you can get his armor, which...
The way I see it,
it's not bad armor, but I'd rather keep him alive. Thank you for a useless item. I'm not using that file with internet, so I will not use that. So what that does, it basically lets you put a summon sign, which lets other players summon you to help with boss fights in certain areas. Ah, a bridge with burnt stuff on it. I wonder what's gonna happen. Oh, a dragon. Or a wyvern, or whatever this thing actually is. Let's head back to this bonfire real quick. Kick down the ladder. Real quick, I'm just gonna get 99 humanities real quick so I don't have to worry about getting them ever again, honestly. Thank you for the 99 humanities, which are basically the items that let you turn back into a human. Not be a zombie. Now we can have more Estus quests until we go to another bonfire. Since there's a dragon on that bridge, we can't go over or around it. Let's go under it. Under where? Under the bridge. Now, this is where it's good to have a spear. Ow. Can you, like, stop, please? Also, a good thing about a spear is since it attack straight, you don't have to worry about hitting walls or anything. Uh-oh. Disgusting rats. These guys are really annoying because they do a lot of poise damage, so you can't really take hits from them. And they poison you, which really sucks. That's not YouTube appropriate. We can have a picture of someone's butt climbing a ladder. That's not nice. Undead parish. Ow. We'll need to get some new armor soon. And you'd think this giant sword would, you know, not be stopped by a shield. Also, see how that gate's up? Normally there's an enemy that, like, that guy runs up to close it. But if you're fast enough, you can go under it before he closes the gate, which I'm gonna try and do. Come on, hurry! Oh, that was really close. I think if he hit me there, I would've died. Thankfully, he closed it just the right time. I actually thought I'd miss it and die, honestly. Alright, let's get one of the best items in the game, in my opinion, the halberd. One of my favorite weapons. Because it's actually kind of broken. Well, not really, but it's just pretty good. Because he can both attack straight and sideways, which is really nice. In my first playthrough of this game, I actually just used the halberd for everything. How much damage does this apply? Like 198. Yeah. Attacks faster, why not? I'll use it for now. The only thing about like spears is, and halberds and things like that is shields. They don't really like them. Uh-oh, we got a big dude. Uh-oh, forgot there's a channel over here. Which are dudes that use magic. And they're not very fun to fight. You have a giant mace. Why are you attacking with your shield? Hopefully we drop some armor. He probably won't, just Titanite. Yep. You basically use Titanite in this game to make your weapons better. Ow. Dude, can you, like, not? Please? Thank you. I take my thank you back. I hope I can get his trident. It's like a 2% drop, I think. Let's open this gate real quick, because I want to fight that giant boar. Hopefully he'll drop his helmet, which is very heavy, but very cool. Alright, dude, hello. You die now. Thank you. Uh-oh, now the piggy's gonna chase me. Armored boar is honestly a real pain to fight, and there's only like four of them in the entire game. They do like a ton of damage, but since my stats are high, it's not. Oop, well, not that was because I wasn't blocking. That was a lot. But even though his armor covers his entire body, still exposed at his butt, which is kind of hard to get a riposte on him. Or that stat, excuse me. Come here. You'd be on flat, even ground to where. Come here, I'm just standing on the butt. What is it? It's right there. Thank you. Ow, 200 damage. That's actually quite a lot. Please give me your helmet. Oof. Well, my first playthrough. I think my first playthrough in this playthrough was the only time I've ever gotten this helmet from that one. This helmet is actually pretty good for early game. It's just really heavy. Although it is pretty cool. Enough mucking about. That sounded like the F word, but that is not what I said. Excuse Nine. Thank you. Also, one thing that's really fun in this game is just you can kick around enemies' corpses, which sounds gross, but is pretty funny. It's a shame they removed that in Dark Souls 2. I don't know about 3, I hope it's still in the 3rd game. What's that hammer? Are we at the local Home Depot? No, it's just a blacksmith. Wow, 50 minutes. It only felt like I'd been playing for 20 minutes, honestly. Hello, sir. You are ripped.
Well, I'm not
even. Reinforce the. Oh, actually. Should purchase. Thank you. Ooh, actually.
I'll get you some nut.
This man must work at Home Depot. Because he's making a jam with that hammer. It's plenty of money to buy all this stuff.
Well, you need it.
Thank you. Anything good? Not really. These shields are like the exact same. I'll take this one. Just in case I have to get more money. I kind of want to keep using this halberd, but to be honest, using more a different type of weapon than what I normally use would be pretty cool. Yeah, I'll stick with this halberd for now. Probably gonna upgrade it to a cool sword I haven't really used before. Oh, that means I'm gonna have to. Just a second. I need to look something up. Make sure I buy the right weapon. Have any curved swords, my main man? No, you do not. Gosh, dang it! I'll buy a falcon from the merchant, other merchant dude. All right, we're almost at the end of this episode. Dexterity, which is another weapon stat. More stamina is always nice. Oh, I forgot to level up my armor. Gosh, dang it. Between videos, I'll probably just grab anything that's kind of out of the way that I want to get. Like, there's a weapon I want to use later, but I need a curved sword for it, so I'll run back to that other shopkeeper we were at and buy one from him. Thankfully, it's actually really cheap in this game to level up armor. Or, I can't really speak for all armors, but at least starting armor. And then I can't level up this helmet because it needs special material, which I can buy later. But we're pretty stacked right now, so is that a thing people still say? Like, I don't really know. Alright, let's go to the first major roadblock boss of the game that most people really struggle with. And actually, I think this, our next boss is, oh gosh, dang it, I keep forgetting to kindle the bonfires I'm at. I have plenty of bones, so I'll just head back real quick. So this next boss we're gonna fight, I'm pretty sure, is where most players who struggle with the game kind of stop, because if you're not really confident or comfortable with controls, you're gonna struggle with this next boss. I'll take care of these guys just real quick, in case they have anything good they want to drop. Did you drop armor? No, only one sword. Also, that elevator is a nice shortcut for later, which I'll use on my way back down from the boss. There he goes. Please, armor. Those guys have really cool armor. I wish they would drop it more often. Alright, next. Onto the room with like 50,000 enemies in it. This room is always just annoying to go through, no matter what loadout you're using. Even though these enemies die in like one hit, it's just annoying. Especially if you're doing like a randomizer where every enemy is randomized. This room is a nightmare. Which I really want to do, like, a randomizer for a game where, like, all the enemies are shuffled around, but I don't really have a way to mod any games. Would be really cool to do, but I prefer to play video games on consoles, which it's not the easiest to modify them. Let's just say that. And I don't really want to mess with the games I have. No armor, not even a sword. Alright, real quick, this is probably the only time in the game where you'll see me make a lot of detours to grab things, but I'm gonna grab the best ring in the game real quick. So normally with this guy, once you free him, he moves to like the main area where you can just kick him off. But he has like the best ring in the game, and I'd like to grab it before we fight the next boss. Also, don't feel bad about killing this NPC because, whoops, he's actually evil. Like, it's not even a joke. There's like a whole quest where if you don't kill him, he kills like a firekeeper, which are like the people keeping the bonfires alive. And you have to like do a whole quest to revive them. But here we are, one of the best rings in the game. Ring of Favor and Protection. It boosts your health, stamina, and how much weight you can hold. But it breaks if you take it off, which, yeah, you'll never need to take it off. Let's just heal real quick. Grab this humanity. Alright, we're gonna go over an hour for this video, unfortunately. But we're not gonna go over an hour and 10 minutes, I promise you that. Probably an hour and 5 minutes. Thankfully, I still have some pine resin, so I can just melt the next boss. Alright. They're just up here. Ooh, Solaire wants to help us out. That's another reason why you, why being a human in this game instead of Hollow is nice, because you can summon NPCs to help you fight bosses, which, if you're good at the game, you don't really need that. But I might as well summon him anyway, because he's like the most popular character in the series, so just summoning in this game is nice because they can distract the bosses, but I honestly don't need them. They're just convenient to have. Alright, we're on the roof of the church. There's the bell up there. I wonder who will be in our way. There's no one here. There's the first bell. Uh-oh. Gargoyles. They look cool. Good thing you're not alive. Wait a minute. They are alive. Uh-oh. He looks strong. Thankfully, there's only one. So with most bosses in this game that have a tail, you can cut it off to get like a special weapon. Uh-oh, there's two of them. Thankfully this one's really easy to deal with because it just breathes fire. There we go. Normally if you don't use the even if you know what you're doing. So that's actually like the first boss most players struggle with. And we're coming up to the end of the episode. So I'm just gonna say in advance, thank you all for watching. I probably will continue playing this game for a video. I'm definitely gonna do a part two. If I remember, I will do a part 3. Maybe even a part 4 if you're lucky. I want to at least make it to the best boss in the game, in my opinion. First bell rung. One more. Then we open the fortress. Alright, that's it. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Have a good day.